Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
Now it is time to start injecting the dependencies in our application. So let us start from the top. These are components. Here we don't need to supply any dependencies. In the data also, no need. Database. Here we have app database. There is no need to supply any dependencies here. Now let me go to repository. I think here we can get started where the real dependency injection starts. Let me open country repository. So what we do is we write class country repository, and in front of that we write inject followed by constructor. We are injecting these dependencies, which are constructor based dependency passing, and just by writing at inject, these dependencies would be supplied by the Hilt dependency injection framework. We have defined country DAO, coroutine dispatcher in the app module. Let me just open the app module side by side. So if you come down here, dispatcher is being supplied from here. DAO is also being supplied from here. So let me close this. With country list service provider, what we can do is we can use the network qualifier, because we want to explicitly mention that we want to fetch the countries from the remote REST-based API service. Now let me go to service, country list service provider network. Once again, I will write inject constructor, and I can actually remove this and pass it as a parameter. And API service is being supplied from the network module. Now let me open country list service provider implementer. Here also we can write at inject constructor, and this is no more needed. I can just use this context. Let me make this private val, and that should take care of the problem. Now let me once again check what other code is there here. Repositories already implemented. Screens is your composable. Here we are supplying view models, but I think this is actually nested inside the scaffold. If you just look at your activity, it has a scaffold, and in the scaffold you have main screen. We are passing operation view model, UI view model by initializing them here. But since now we are using Hilt framework to supply these dependencies, we can basically remove this. And then this is the old code wherein we were using the manual container based dependency injection. That is no more needed. We will replace that with Hilt view model. If you recall, we have defined our view models with Hilt view model annotation. Here also we need to apply inject constructor, and we need to do the same in operation view model as well. Inject constructor. Now we can pass these operation view models where we need in our application. So what we will do is, let me go to the scaffold, and initially we will try to pass them via here. This is a temporary measure. We will go to main activity, and here we will define both the view models and pass it as argument to country info app scaffold. What we can do is we will write private well country view model, and by view models is basically a delegate method provided by activity component, and it allows you to supply view model that you have defined using the Hilt framework. I can pretty much do the same with operation view model and then pass these as arguments, and that's it. However, this is discouraged. There is even a better refined way to write it. Instead of manually initializing these in the activity and then passing here as an argument, we can directly initialize it here itself. And to do that, we will have to add certain dependencies. So let me open the build.gradle, and here there is another dependency that we can add, which is implementation android x dot hilt navigation compose. if we just add and sync it now and go back to our scaffold, what I can do is I can remove this. Let me enable this particular code. I can initialize it with Hilt model, and that makes it much more cleaner. And if you come back here, we don't need to supply this, and this code can be completely eliminated. Now, if you just check your whole application, this is our scaffold. It needs view models, and that are supplied from Hilt. Why? Because both of these view models are using Hilt, that is country UI view model and operation view model. And then repository is also being supplied through the app modules, that is here. All the dependencies are now being supplied from the modules that we have defined here in the DI package. And with this, our application looks much better. And now, whatever the container that we had initialized earlier, this is not needed anymore. I can basically delete this. And even this one, singleton app container, which we were using to do the manual dependency injection, that is also not needed anymore. So I can basically even delete that as well. And country info application is now annotated with Hilt Android application. And this is how you use Hilt dependency injection framework to supply dependencies. Let me run the application now. We are getting some error here. Country DAO provide country repository. Yeah, I think the problem is this should be returned as iCountryDAO because that is an interface. And that is what we are returning here. And let me run this now. Yeah, it's working perfectly fine. And this is what our application is. So basically, we started our application without any dependency injection. And then we did the manual dependency injection. And now finally, we have replaced the manual dependency injection with Hilt dependency injection. So with this, we are basically ending dependency injection series, where we finally have understood the end-to-end implementation of what is dependency injection, how it is supposed to be implemented without any framework, and then with a framework. All the other dependency injection frameworks pretty much use the same concept. If you want to use, instead of Dagger and Hilt, want to use, say, Coin, it pretty much works on the same concept, just that the syntax and semantics would be slightly different. So this should give you a pretty good basic understanding of how to think using dependency injection frameworks when you are doing dependency injection, and also give you a very good understanding of what is dependency injection. In the next video, we will come with the new topic. So stay tuned. That
brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.